All right, good evening, everybody. This is a special Facebook version update of the evening setup here. I know there's a lot of buzz about Storm on the internet. I wanted to give you a look at what I'm seeing before I hit the hay and have to wake up way too early and start looking at some new models, which, by the way, are going to come out in just a couple of hours. This is a water vapor loop. This is our 24-hour loop version of the satellite. There's a better version than the infrared, showing us high moisture content, the bright whites and the darker shadings. Where it's relatively dry. Again, we've had our chance to clear out this evening. That's good news for us, but this gets your attention. This low pressure system is occluded. It's actually taken some dry air, wrapped it around the center, cuts off its source of energy, and it sits and spins. And this particular one is going to sit and spin and create some problems in the mid and upper levels of the atmosphere. And it's probably going to stall out somewhere between Michigan, Indiana, and Ohio. I know I said Iowa earlier this afternoon, but it's really going to be this general vicinity. And that is important because this is going to start being referred to like the remnants of Tropical Storm Lee. It is not a tropical storm, but it's going to end up in a very similar location. And the atmosphere a lot of times likes to repeat itself in these patterns. Remember, Lee came up across New Orleans, dumped a couple of feet of rain down here, worked its way through the Appalachians, sort of stalled to our west, worked westward, and then finally pulled through after a few days. It also tapped into some moisture from a tropical system in the southern Gulf. That's not the case right now, but you could see that tropical feed and all that flare-up of thunderstorms, southern Alabama, Georgia, Florida, and South Carolina this afternoon. Now, this particular region is going to be important because we have a southeast wind. You probably already noticed the added humidity coming in here. Well, that wind direction and all that moisture from the south is going to feed into this upcoming system. All right, let's first take a look here at the surface map. This is what it looks like. I blew it up maybe a little blurry just to highlight. There's our occluded front highlighting the wraparound and how this thing is now cutting itself or choking itself off from its moisture source, but it still is a vigorous spin. But we do have moisture that's going to feed in from the Gulf and off the Atlantic and pull it right through the East Coast. That is bad news. Now, the other setup we had a few weeks ago also had a Hurricane Katia out here blocking this thing from going into the Atlantic. That's not the case now, but there will be a developing high pressure that blocks this from Canada. And essentially, it's going to look very similar to what happened just a couple of weeks ago. So let's show you at least just one computer model, give you a sample. This is a four-panel of the GFS, Global Forecasting System. That's your upper level 500 millibar. Think about that as the jet stream. This is your surface to 500. Think about this as just your regular surface map you may see on TV or who watches, reads the paper anymore, but your highs and your lows. This 700 panel, that's our moisture content. Think about that as cloud level. Denser cloud cover is going to be the deeper greens. The dry air is going to be in those brown orange shadings. And this lower right panel, this is going to be your average rainfall 6-hour precip accumulation. And it's going to reset itself every time we go through a frame. I'm going to put this in motion, 180 hours here, and just watch that circulation right there across the Great Lakes. And it seems to just stall out. This is Saturday, going into Sunday, going into early Monday. Last couple of frames looks like it's just to our southwest or pulling right into central Maryland. One more loop, you're actually going to notice one of these little pieces of energy, a little vortmax riding up. That's bad news. That's Thursday into Friday, and that is when we could wind up with some big-time problems as we could have some heavy rainfall. Then the upper-level system pulls through, and again, this is actually taking us Tuesday morning, and we have an area low pressure at the surface, and also aloft, that's just stuck, and it's just pumping in some moisture. Let's put this into motion on the surface features, and you're going to notice there's our upper low. It's going to sort of work itself out as we get some blocking high in Canada and pretty much have this thing not identify itself very well on the surface, but you do see what happens here. And that area low pressure is really going to help to feed in some moisture, and you can see how this plays out here in our precip panel. And let's just take it back to the first frame. I'm going to do this bit by bit and take us on in through Thursday 0Z. This is Wednesday evening. We have some spotty showers. Let's bring you on into Thursday itself. Watch the moisture gather. This takes us on into Thursday evening. Again, for reference, there's Maryland. Let's pull it on into Friday. There's some heavy rainfall around here. Works itself up into New England. Bad news for them. They've already had flooding like we had too. And then it just works its way into the weekend. Not a complete deluge at this point, but now we're looking Saturday, Sunday, Ocean City, Sunfest. Yeah, we got some rain off the coast. And you just take this with a grain of salt. Once we start getting out now, 132, 144 hours, we got more rain. We got this stuff just sitting and spinning on top of us. And unfortunately, this is how it plays out from at least the look from the National Weather Service. This is actually from HPC, the Hydrometeorological Prediction Center. Yeah, say that five times fast. It's a five-day accumulation. This bar here, this legend, 3 inches plus in the red shading. And there we are in central Maryland, right on the edge. Looks like we're 3 inches plus. That's 7.6 knot. That's off the coast of Ocean City and Virginia Beach. But an idea of all that heavy convection and moisture pulling itself up to the north. Oh, does that look so much like what Lee tried to do for us? Although we had some of that locked in over central Maryland. You got to take this with a grain of salt, okay? Don't marry yourself to a model 5 days away. But the whole pattern is evolving that is going to take what is developing here, stalling it, tapping into tropical moisture. It will look like what Lee did to us a couple of weeks ago. Doesn't mean the same thing's going to happen to Ellicott City or even west of D.C., but somebody is going to get hammered with some heavy rain. That's what I'm looking at right now this evening. Look, the new models are being generated right now, and we'll have to see how this thing evolves, but wanted to give you an idea on how I see it and how other people might be buzzing about it. Plan for the end of the week for it to increase, maybe the heaviest Thursday night, Friday morning, and then a couple of more shots over the weekend into early next week. Yes, the weekend outlook has changed because of this bugger. Now, depending on where it stalls, if it stalls that long or if it moves on sooner, really could change the outlook here. So stay tuned. I got to hit the hay. I'll see y'all tomorrow.